Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. I want to read Matthew 7. I read verses 13 and 14. Look into your Bible just in case I have not read them right there. And it says, enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. But straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth to life, and few there be that find it. This is my heart's desire. Most of us do not even know the meaning of what we are singing. We sing because the melody is sweet, because it is a popular song or a danceable song. But do you really mean what you are saying to God? Are you really giving your life to Him? Are you really asking Him to have His way in you? Or we are in church to play ceremony? Amen.
Amen.
I'm not here to play ceremony. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want us for once. 2016, signs and wonders. There are different things that make up signs and wonders. You don't know what it is. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to really think about this song. I'm not singing it because I want to make fashion. No. I'm singing it because it is a prayer and a talk with God. Listen, this good teacher said, are you committed to God? He said, Apostle Paul, he told him, if you go to Jerusalem, he said, trials and persecutions are awaiting you. And she now asked, how many of us, if your pastor should tell you, go to Rome, and when you are preparing to go to Rome, they tell you when you go there because you are going for the gospel, they are going to beat you, they are going to arrest you, and they are going to deport the person. Will you still say, I will go? And Apostle Paul said, it doesn't matter whether tribulations and persecutions are waiting for me, I will go. But in our days now, somebody will say, wisdom is the principal thing. The same Bible that is telling you to be committed, you will use it against God, not to do God's work. I started saying this about 3 days ago. I told you, we now quote God's word against God. I'm sorry I'm keeping you standing, but stand for God, not for me. Amen?
Amen.
Be patient with me. You know, whenever I come here, I want us to get it. When it gets to my turn to face persecution, to face insults, signs and wonders, what if part of the sign is for you to be insulted, for you to be clothed with shame? You say, I bind it in Jesus' name for the gospel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please, I want to worship God. Don't worry, the message is so brief, so I have enough time. But I want to worship God. And I want you to worship Him. I want you to reverence Him. Bless God. Open your mouth and begin to bless Him. Open your mouth. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Your money cannot bribe God, but your worship can move Him. Your worship can make Him do something for you. Your worship can cause heaven to be open unto you. Jesus, we are in your presence. Let it rain.
Let's go!
even if they are going to beat me and put me in prison, and after that deport me, Lord, I will still go as long as it's for you.
Amen.
I will not tell you that wisdom is the principal thing. But I will not quote your word that says, be as wise as a serpent. No, Lord, I will go. I will go. Because this is what tells me, Lord, that he that will love his life to keep it shall lose it. But he that for your sake will lose it shall gain it. Lord, I'm willing to lose my life. And you know it, God, that I'm willing to lose my life. I want you to talk to God before I open my mouth, Jesus. I don't know about you. You can't enter heaven by mistake. Then how can you enter heaven by fake church? Jesus. Holy Spirit, you're welcome.
Amen.
Over to you.
Amen.
Speak to us.
Yes.
Let this word not fall on the ground void.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let this word fall on fruitful soil. You may be seated in his presence. And quickly pick your Bibles and hold it. I want to talk about a topic I call Choose Your Place of Eternity. Amen. For those that have been coming for Wednesday's service, it will look like a continuation or a part. Praise the Lord. And for God to give me this message, I believe that, like somebody said, it's a message for everybody. A lot of us here that are here, when it says we don't come. But when it says we hear some things, we hear some things. Amen.
Amen.
Some of us don't come because of our work, our jobs. But most of us don't come because we don't really care. Amen.
Amen.
Like some of us don't come for service until 12 o'clock, we will not take our bath, so that will be here by 1. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Let us read again Matthew chapter 7. Choose your place of eternity. Amen. You cannot bribe your way into heaven. I cannot bribe my way into heaven. Hello? Whether you like it or you don't like it, you believe it or you don't believe it, hell is real, very real. And hell is not even the final destination. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because the Bible says, death that took those that die and will die, and hell shall be cast into the lake of fire. So hell is just a temporary place for now. Hello. It is not the same fire you used to cook a small pot in your house, that when you want to cook for the whole church, you use the same pot and the same fire. Share the fire will be bigger. Amen.
Amen.
I want to read again, and we'll read some, do some love reading, and I will leave you to judge for yourself, as God left me to judge for myself. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. How many of us want to make heaven? Don't raise your hand until you are sure. Think about it. You want to. I didn't say you will. I said you want to. Amen.
Amen.
Now, let me tell you something. The fact that you have a visa does not mean that you go to the country where you collected the visa. In fact, a lot of us collected visa for countries that we never went to. Amen. And the fact that you bought a ticket, in which you have a visa, a ticket, so you are qualified for the trip. Say, are you born again? Say, yes. Yes, it is your ticket to heaven, your visa. But it does not mean that it's your permission to sojourn. Hello. You may get to the airport, pass through the controls without your boarding pass. With your ticket and your visa, they will send you back. How many of us know that? No boarding pass. How did you, in the first place, you are a suspect. How did you pass the control? But you have all it takes to make it. I'm born again. I come to church. I have the visa. I have the ticket. Does not mean that you enter heaven. Amen. I want to read again verse 13 of Matthew 7. It says, enter ye in the straight gate. A straight gate means a tight gate, very tight. Amen. You see this staircase, maximum two people can walk at the same time, but it will be very uncomfortable. Imagine if five people want to pass through this staircase at the same time. It will be too tight. Amen. It says, enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. And what bothers me is that it says, and many there be which go thereat. Because the Bible says, Jesus said, there's a way that seems right unto a man. He said, but the end of that way is death. Most of us have forgotten this Bible, the truth. The only thing we know about this Bible is that you shall prosper in Jesus' name. You shall be blessed. Anybody pursuing you shall die by fire, by thunder. Everybody will shout amen. Yes. But is that your ticket to heaven? If after all your enemies die here, just like it to you with that because you are an enemy to somebody, where are you going? Have you made provisions for the country you are going to after this place? Or you think that heaven is fantasy and hell is a dream? God is a good God. He will not send us to hell. Ha ha ha. We will read from Revelation. Verse 14 says, it said, because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth to life, and few there be that find it. Now, it didn't say few there be that go. It said few that find it. The other one, many that go there. That means they don't even look for the thing is wide open. Everybody, you go there. If you are in Torino and you come across somebody and you are saying Porta Palace, and the person says, I don't know where is Porta Palace. I say, you give me this, you'll be surprised, won't you? That the person doesn't know Porta Palace. There are very few that don't know Porta Palace. But there are so many that go there. Because they think things are cheap there. It's a lie. Things are even more expensive. So also, the road that looks so good, we are in the modern days, God has updated. You know, Pastor was talking about sin. Praise the Lord. You cannot enter heaven by chance. You enter heaven by choice. Your eternity, whether you make a decision or not, it becomes a decision. Your decision to go to heaven is also your decision not to go to hell. Your decision not to take a decision is a decision to go to hell. Hello? It is not my coming out several times to give my life to Christ, and I never really give my life, and I know it. Or my coming to church, or even my carrying this microphone to preach or to teach, that gives me the ticket, or that gives me the permission to sojourn to enter heaven. Does God know you? A lot of you know me, you know my name. Some people even know my house. But how many body, How many persons here can actually beat their chest? Sister Bart, I think I was saying, I said, can you claim to know me? You say, Sister, I know you. Maybe one person. In fact, the person said, still reading me like a book, and I asked which page. He said, not the same page where I didn't ask today. Amen. That's the only person that actually knows me a bit. It's still in one page. So do you know God? Is it by coming to church that shows that you know God? Because if you do not know him, he doesn't know you. I don't think you don't allow strangers into your house. So God cannot allow strangers into his house. Hello? Let me show us something. Brothers and sisters, heaven is real. Hell is real. Jesus is coming again. Have you decided which side you will go on that day? Like I told them on Wednesday service, because we are talking about the end times, and I think we began to talk about the rapture that most of us don't know, and the second coming of Christ. It doesn't matter whether you are alive when Jesus comes or you are dead. What is important is, are you in him? This is the crucial point. Many of us don't know what is the great tribulation, but we have heard of 666. And some of us are already candidate for 666 and we know it not. We flow with everything. Amen. Have you made a choice? Have you chosen the direction? Now, if you choose to go in a particular direction, you made a choice to go to a country like China and you are going to spend 10 years in China, it will be foolish of you if before you go to China, you don't start learning how to greet in Chinese. Am I right? You begin to prepare to go. So that when you get there, you will be, thank you. It will be completely new to you. So that when they say, Wacha, why? You two will say, Yaha, cha. Don't be deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he reap. If you do not prepare your door for heaven, heaven gates will not be open to you. Hell is wide open. The doors are never closed. Revelations. This dress is already dragged my leg. Amen. I want to read two chapters of Revelations. Please be patient. Let me read them. How many of us normally read the book of Revelations? You normally, not once in a while. Don't read it at night, otherwise you have nightmares. Praise the Lord. But I want to read chapters 15 and 16. Oh, will Sister Faith be so nice to read it very fast for us? Revelations 15. Revelations 15.
Verse 1.
Read.
And I saw another sign in heaven, great and marvelous, seven angels having the seven last plagues, for in them is filled up the wrath of God.
Stop. The wrath of God. Do you know what is a wrath? If na anger, it go good. Say the person in verse. Now that kind of vexation will not get cure. And nobody can stop it. One time in our life, all of us, we have been that angry that even the person that will try to placate us, we are ready to even finish that person. That is wrath. The end result of wrath is destruction, irreparable destruction. Go on, man.
Verse 2. And I saw as it were a sea of glass mingled with fire, and them that had gotten the victory over the beast, and over his image, and over his mark, and over the number of his name, stand on the sea of glass, having the harps of God, and they sing the songs of Moses, the servants of God and the song of the Lamb, saying, great and marvelous are thy works, Lord God Almighty, just and true are thy ways, thou King of saints, who shall not fear the Lord, who shall not fear thee, O Lord, and glorify thy name, for thou only art holy, for all nations shall come and worship before thee, for thy judgments are made manifest. And after that I looked, and behold, the temple of the tabernacle of the testimony in heaven was opened, and the seven angels came out of the temple, having the seven plates, clothed in pure and white linen, and having their breasts girded with golden girdles. And one of the four beasts gave unto the seven angels seven golden vials full of the wrath of God, who liveth forever and ever. And the temple was filled with smoke from the glory of God and from his power, and no man was able to enter into the temple till the seven plagues of the seven angels were filled.
Amen. Say, I have no appointment with tribulation. Say it to yourself.
I have no appointment with tribulation.
I refuse to have appointment with tribulation.
I have refused to have appointment with tribulation.
I will not pass through the great tribulation.
I will not pass through the great tribulation.
I shall be raptured.
I shall be raptured.
I shall be raptured.
I shall be raptured.
I'm not joking. Whether dead or alive, I shall be raptured.
Whether dead or alive, I shall be raptured.
Therefore, I make a choice. Now, in this chapter, the Bible tells us about some few people that have been saved and are found with God. But I want us to look at verse 7 and 8. It said, seven angels were given seven containers full of the wrath of God. Amen. And the Bible says, the temple of God was filled with the glory of God, the smoke, and nobody was able to enter in until the wrath of God was completed. Let me tell you what it means. Now you can plead the blood of Jesus. When you sing, you say, Father, forgive me in Jesus' name. A time is coming, the name of Jesus will not do it for you. In the days after the rapture, if you want to be saved, you will be saved by your blood like in the days of old. The blood of Jesus will not come to rescue you, because before that time, you refused to acknowledge the blood of Jesus. You were in church, yes. You were coming to church, yes. You were being blessed, yes. You gave offering, yes. But you never acknowledged Jesus. He was never your Lord, neither your Master. Hello?
Hi.
Do you know who is your master? When you say, this person is my master. A lot of us love Jesus being our Savior, but as our Lord, as our master. Mm-mm. So you give to Caesar what is Caesar, and you give to God what is God. But what belongs to Caesar, that Caesar made for himself, that God has not created? He said, nothing, nothing, until his word was fulfilled. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, man. Let me read, because I'm a faster. I will run through the 16. He said, and I heard a great voice out of the temple saying to the eternal angels, I'm reading chapter 16, go your ways and pour out the vials of the wrath of God upon the earth. Now, I choose to read this to give you a picture. Before this time, they have been terrible things happening. Just like now. If you hear that a mother suddenly took her newborn baby and put the child in the freezer because the temperature was high, and she forgot to remove the child, by the time she remembered the child was a nice blood, you say that devil